Hey, what's going on? I am Brother Brion Everwell, Africa Bay. Right now, we're going to basically talk about the 360 degrees that are in a circle versus the 365 days that are surmounted to be a year. It's important that we remember that the planet Earth itself is broken up into degrees, and there can only be 360 degrees. Because of the education and socialization, we've come up with reasons to suggest that there is 365 days in a year. It's really crazy how some people can suggest that is even accurate. And I know a lot of people go into the whole leap year theory and things like that, but nobody's paying attention to the fact that, well, if there is such a thing as time and it all starts off at zero, why does it even matter to have a leap year? And if you're considering it from a mathematical perspective, the Earth is making its way around this ball of energy, a point in space, and time is supposedly dictated by the positions, the equivalent or the closest equivalents of positions in regards to where the planet is sitting versus where the sun is sitting. And so all of these have surmounted to equal close to 24 days an hour, 24 hours in a day. And so if we're breaking it down evenly as the way all circles are, and then you will still come to the conclusion that it's going to be 23 hours and some blah 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 blah, which again equates to the same as what we're using when we look at the 24 day hour. 24-hour day, I'm sorry. This is, I guess, what you would call a madness that probably has resulted from the miseducation. Simple as that. Miseducation, ritualism, and indoctrination. The ritual side of it is more or less the fact that we do so many things at this point in what we're calling time, that it seems only right after a few hundred years. So the celebration of Thanksgiving, and then eventually on into Christmas, and then the New Year, and things like that. I mean, a majority of the people have totally forgotten about the solstice and the shortest day of the year and things like that. Totally forgot about it. And now we're looking at what we're taught, what we've learned here in regards to Christmas, and saying, oh yes, it's all about Christmas and the holiday season and things like that. But again, let's go back to the 360 days a year. If we go with the 360 days a year, then a year is actually complete, because then we've based the way that we're living our life off of nature. But when we use 365 days a year, then we find ourselves, again, having to deal with that whole leap year thing, which we don't really have to anyway, because, again, it's the fact that somebody has chosen to go around here saying there's 31 days in this month, and 30 days in this month, 31 days in this month. The 30 days are just degrees. There's 12 months in a year. 360 degrees. The adding of all of these different numbers and fractions and things like that, it complicates things. However, if you just look at the sky and take count and take note, you will eventually see that it equates to 360 days a year. Simple as that. Plain as day. My imagination.
running away with me.
It was just like... And with time being an individual percept, or basically a concept, time has nothing to do with nature itself. Because nature, or each individual item that is within nature, is really made up of another conglomeration of individual items. So it's the concept of time is really it's a carnal concept. As I said earlier, it's a percept with cells being being able to change and alter themselves at different rates than the next cell based on the environment that it's in. The shifting, or the what we use to denote age and things like that, or what we use to denote age is more or less an example of the environment that we have been exposed to and how this environment has affected us. The best example that I can use is that some people look younger than what they really are, and some people look older than what they really are. And a lot of times it's based on the cell structure and the environment that the cell has been exposed to. You can have a 10-year-old who plays with toys all day, knows nothing about cooking, starting fires, or any of that stuff, and is pretty much in need of some sort of mothering. And then on the other side of the planet, in the bush somewhere, you can also have a 10-year-old who hunts and kills and knows how to start a fire, knows how to cook and take care of itself and its other family members. Okay, this is based on, again, the experience. So is it safe to suggest that because both of these people were born at the same time, that they are both 10 years old?